two narrow tubes of diameter D1 and D2, they are joined together to form a U-tube, which is open at what? Both the ends. So here we are having two narrow tubes, one is of diameter D1, other is of diameter D2, they are joined together so as to form a U-tube, which is open at both the end. Now if U-tube contains water, see here, inside that U-tube there is a water whose angle of contact theta is 0, means cos 0 is 1. So if U-tube contains water, the difference in water level in the limb is, so this is one of the limb of U-tube and here this is the another limb. So difference in the limb of, difference in water level in the limb means here H we have to find out. If I say H1 is the height of liquid level in first limb, H2 is the height of liquid level in the second limb, then we have to find out H, which is equal to H1 minus of H2, H1 minus of H2. Now see here, what is given? T is the surface tension of water, angle of contact for water is 0, density of water is rho, and G is acceleration due to gravity. We know that rise of liquid in a capillary tube or rise of liquid in a narrow tube, it was given by formula H is equal to 2T cos of theta divided by R rho G, divided by what? R rho G. And for water, theta is equal to 0, cos theta means cos 0 is equal to 1, it means that H is equal to 2T divided by R rho into G, 2T divided by what? R rho G. So H1 is height of liquid level in one of the limb and H2 is height of liquid level in the other limb. So the difference between the liquid level in the two limbs of manometer, H, which is equal to H1 minus of H2, and that is equal to, see here, liquid is a water, surface tension is same, rho, density of water is same, and G, acceleration due to gravity is also same. So this is equal to 2T divided by rho G, 2T divided by rho G. And now as far as the radius is concerned, see here, radius, 2 times radius is equal to diameter, therefore D1 is equal to 2R1, or R1 is equal to D1 by 2, R2 is equal to D2 by 2, R2 is equal to what? D2 by 2, therefore H1 minus H2 is equal to 2T upon rho G, and that in place of R1, now here we can write 1 upon D1 by 2. 1 upon what? D1 by 2 minus 1 upon D2 by 2 minus 1 upon D2 by 2. So H becomes equal to, therefore from here onward, H becomes equal to, see here, this 2 will come in numerator, so outside the bracket it is 4T divided by rho G, 4T divided by rho G in bracket 1 upon D1 minus of 1 upon D2, 1 upon D1 minus of what? 1 upon D2. Therefore, H, which is equal to H1 minus H2 is equal to 4T divided by rho G in bracket it is D2 minus D1, D2 minus D1 divided by D1 into D2, D1 into D2. So, see which option is correct? Option B. It is 40 upon rho G in bracket D2 minus D1 upon D1 into D2. 40 upon rho G, D2 minus D1 upon D1 into D2. So B is the correct option for this question.